previously on Taken.
We took this craft apart more than 10 years ago, and we still have no idea how it ran.
In fact, we know less now than we did when we found the damn thing.
The power of mind. That is the energy source your scientists have been unable to find.
Well, what do you suggest we do, Doctor?
Find someone else with unimaginable power of mind.
Jacob!
I'm never gonna fly your saucer. Not ever.
It'll go easier for your mom if you help me out. You know that.
I'm not the only one that matters.
Hey, Jesse.
You know, your father, he was a real hero once. A real hero.
Jesse's in danger. I need to talk
to him. It's not gonna happen, Russell.
What I can't understand is why am I alive?
You have something in the blood, something that makes you special.
No!
Can you keep them coming back for me again?
I'm sure as hell gonna try.
Okay, Jesse is special. They're seeing if he's ready.
Ready for what?
Get away from me!
Mr. Crawford, look at me.
No, no, no!
He has to disappear. If they come looking for him, there can't be a trace.
That boy in Texas?
There was a fire. The kid died, sir.
Good.
You keep this safe from me, okay? I may not ever see you again.
I love you, love.
My grandfather used to tell my mom that kids should never have to worry about anything more serious than baseball. Everything you need to know is there. It has success and failure, moments where you come together and moments where you stand alone. And it has an ending. Not a clock like in other sports, but an ending. And that, my grandfather used to say to my mom, is as close as a kid should have to come to that sort of thing.
Lift that bat. 1, 2, 3. Hey, batter, batter, batter. Nothing, man. Just get another. Two more like that, and we can go home.
Hey, batter, batter, batter.
Oh. You all right, kid?
You know my name?
Of course.
Everyone here calls me Jack.
You know who I am? You have certain capabilities. We both know what I'm talking about. You mustn't use them again. They're what's making you sick.
What happens if I do use them?
At best, you'll burn them out, lose them for good. At worst, they'll take your mind with them when they go, and the strain of it could kill you.
I'm sorry.
It's all right. We'll find another way. Who's going to take the series?
The Yankees in 7.
Is that a guess or something else?
I guess.
I think you're right.
Marshall Bridges trying to get him out. Checks his sign with Elston Howard. Here's the 1-2 pitch. He swings it a long belt to right field. It's well hit. Harris back at the fence. It's gone.
Jack? Jack?
I'm Dr. Benson. I'm sorry I wasn't here to see you earlier, son, but when you're the only doctor for 500 square miles, everybody expects you to be in three places at once. Now, let's take a look at you and see what's keeping you off the diamond.
People like to examine the things that frighten them, to look at them and give them names. So saints look for God and scientists look for evidence. They're both just trying to take away the mystery, to take away the fear.
Let me ask you this. There were, if I remember from the report, four bodies on the craft.
The craft held five, Mr. President. We brought back four. This one was still alive when we brought him in. I don't know if you've seen the reports on that.
Yes, I have. Quite a time he gave you there. And the fifth?
We never recovered that body, sir.
I see. Well, it certainly doesn't look as if they mean to attack us.
What makes you say that, sir?
Well, from what you've told me, if that was their intention, we'd all be dead by now.
We have 1 month to prove to him that our visitors are a threat. After that, he's shutting us down and redirecting all the funds of the space program. The arrogant son of a bitch. I need proof that there's a clear and present danger. I need a smoking gun, gentlemen, and I need it now.
My best subject in school was algebra. People always say algebra's hard, but that is because they don't get how easy it is. I just loved all those X's. Anything you don't know, you just put down an X. Or you can go with Y's or A's and B's. In real life, you have 1 + 1, and if it doesn't equal 2, you're up a creek. But in algebra, it always works, no matter what the answer is. You just have to figure out what X is. That's a very beautiful thing. Oh, hey, honey, let me show you. Just let me do one. Let me show you.
Mom.
It's fine, honey. Mommy is going to fix that.
Why don't you go and lie down?
Oh, X marks the spot.
How many drinks have you had?
Several.
How many pills?
Several.
Those pills are for your nerves. They're not to be taken willy-nilly.
Oh, willy-nilly, eh?
Lie down before you fall down. Finish your schoolwork for us. You're disgusting.
You sober up, or I'll have you put someplace. And get in bed.
Don't come out of your room until morning. Best thing, brother, I got it. I got it.
Sorry to bother you, sir. You said you wanted to see these as soon as possible.
Yes, of course. Come on in.
Two possibilities, sir. Both very credible. Gail Arlen has reported repeated encounters since 1960. Divorced, no children, lives alone.
My doctor told me it would reduce my tension.
Betty and Barney Hill. Encounters in 1961 on the way back from Niagara Falls. He's a postal clerk and she's a child welfare worker. They're both active in their community. They've begun some sort of therapy using hypnosis. They're very solid.
Very solid, sir. In both these cases, the people claimed that they were taken aboard a craft.
Taken?
Yes, sir.
Could be just what we need. Lonely divorcee. Makes up stories to get attention. Hypnosis, you say?
Medical hypnosis, like they use on amnesia victims.
No, no Negroes. It clouds the issue.
Sir.
Just keep trying. There must be somebody out there.
Yes, sir.
What the Russians want is nothing less than world domination. Communism is a religion, a faith like any other, with a holy text and saints and martyrs. The Russians see themselves as crusaders in a holy war.
Is there any reason you're not under your desk, Jack?
I don't see the point.
The point is to be ready.
In the event of a nuclear attack on the Great Falls Air Force Base, which is the only military target within 500 miles, the initial blast would be jarring, but it wouldn't even break our windows.
You don't take the threat of nuclear attack seriously, then?
On the contrary, sir, I believe that within 3 days of an initial attack, 3/4 of the world would have been destroyed. I don't see the point of hiding from that kind of destruction under a desk.
Everybody back in their seats.
Yankees lead 1-0, the bottom of the ninth.
Russell? Yeah, I'm heading to lunch. You want to keep an ear open for the phone?
Yeah, I'm on it. Hey, Jess.
Who's winning?
That 1-0 Yankees. Bottom of the ninth, 2 outs, and Mays just doubled. You like baseball? Force of nature, those Yanks. How'd you know I was here?
I heard Mom talking to Dad. To Bill. She said you got a job as close as you were legally allowed. And she wanted him to come over and tell you to go someplace else.
Well, he did. You grew up.
I've been reading in these books about how the government knows about flying saucers. I'm afraid if they tell us, there'll be panic.
They started taking you again.
It says in there where it's mostly the Air Force that knows about them. Sort of was thinking. I mean, you were a pilot and all. Why don't we go tell them?
Yeah. Why don't we?
I'm sorry. We got some kind of exercise just started. It's got the whole base turned upside down. Captain, real pleasure to meet you. My mom said my dad always spoke very highly of you.
He was the best bombardier I ever saw. Don't think he ever missed. He's a good friend of mine. How's your mother doing?
She's doing fine.
Good. You speak to her, let her know I sent my best.
Sure will. You gonna join the service like your dad?
I might, sir.
It's a good life. Well, you said on the phone there was something I could help you with.
Flying saucers.
I'm sorry.
My father and I have both seen them. We've both been inside them.
You both seen them? Let me just get this all on record for you, then.
How long after we left his office do you think he threw that report in the trash?
We weren't even out of the building.
You didn't believe us at all.
No.
There's gotta be another way.
The people who aren't involved are all gonna be like Lieutenant Wiley. They'll smile politely and think we're crazy.
So how do we get to the people who are involved?
I just don't know if they can do anything for us, Jesse. Hey. I will do whatever it takes to help you.
Thank you.
Hey, Gus, you might want to open a window. Smell of it. Can't eat.
What do you want?
Two bacon, lettuce, and tomato sandwiches, and a cup of coffee.
Okay. Give you a cup of coffee. There you go.
Wrong with your old man.
Hey, get a napkin first, pal. Something so he won't bite his tongue off. Here, help me roll him on his side so he doesn't choke and he vomits. Call an ambulance. Tell him this man is having a grand mal seizure. I'm a med student at U of U. I know what I'm talking about. Do it now! It's all right, sir. You're gonna be all right. An ambulance is on the way.
You're in the infirmary at the Air Force Base. You had a seizure at the diner and they brought you here. Guess there are some benefits to being a vet.
I had this headache. And there were gunshots.
Yeah.
Are you all right?
Yeah, they weren't shooting at me.
Those two colored guys that came in, did they get hurt?
Nobody got hurt. You think the seizures had anything to do with our friends?
Could be. Could also be the end result of those fists of vodka I hit myself in the head with every night for 8 years.
Captain Keyes. How are you feeling?
Why don't you tell me, Doc?
This kind of thing ever happened to you before?
Yeah, once. I was home and next thing I knew it was 2 hours later and I sort of rearranged the furniture. Headaches are pretty constant, though.
I'd like to take you down to X-ray, see if we can find anything.
You need to lie very still. Try not to move.
We all like to think that we have some control over the events in our lives. And a lot of the time, we can fool ourselves into thinking that we really are in charge. But then something happens to remind us that the world runs by its own rules and not ours, and that we're just along for the ride.
May I speak frankly in front of your son? You have a tumor. It's in the frontal lobe of your brain. It's very, very small, but it appears to be putting pressure on your brain in unusual ways.
Can you take it out?
I've never seen anything quite like this on an X-ray before. You might live a long and happy life, marred only by occasional headaches, perhaps more seizures like the one that brought you in here. or it might kill you tomorrow. I'm sorry.
Doctor, can you give me the same test you just gave my dad? See if I have a tumor in my head too.
Exactly the same size, in exactly the same place. What are the odds?
The nature of the encounter seems to have changed. We have stories of missing time. People are losing several hours of their lives. In a few cases, hypnotherapy has filled in those missing hours, giving us a story of a meeting with the little men that is reminiscent of some of my country's experiments during the war. But these are more than mere meetings. These are, for lack of a better word, abductions.
That's new. In the past, exposure for more than 10 minutes was fatal.
So we know they learned from their mistakes. Their technology evolves. Something has changed in their agenda. Or if not their overall view, certainly their methodology. They are upping the ante, I believe you say.
Why now?
Why not?
Can we prove this?
Well, we are working.
No, I need the most credible of these people. I need evidence, like a drop in Kennedy's lap before he pulls our plug. Who do you have for me?
Well, I went in to get some ice cream, and I saw the light out the kitchen window. Bam! Refrigerator falls over, plates start flying off the shelves. It's like sitting on the back of a wet dog. He's just shaking himself dry.
It was the same in the living room. Everything's falling, the house is shaking.
I managed to crawl back in through the kitchen, and that's pretty much it. Next thing Susan and I know, we're back on the couch, and it's 2 a.m.
That's 3.5 hours we lost.
I'd like to try to get those 3.5 hours back for you. This is wonderful coffee.
Oh, thank you.
They're not coming back for these people.
Call it a gut instinct, whatever you like. They're one-timers, like when a fisherman throws back the little ones. What you have to find me are the keepers, and you have to find them yesterday. I know I've threatened you both in the past with reassignment and with worse. And I'm sure I don't need to tell you how hard it'll be for all of us to go back to a conventional military life if the president chooses to shut us down. But at least for me, there's the comfort that I will have a rank, a position, and a place to go. When I took over this operation for my wife's father, I made certain provisions for all the men who were assigned to me. Your names, ranks, and serial numbers no longer exist in any personnel file or other military record. You are, in effect, non-people. Without this organization, I'm afraid you'll find yourself hard-pressed to have a life.
I've said this before, Marty, but that is one nasty bastard.
What are we going to do?
You remember Jacob Clark?
The only person I've ever heard of that scared the Colonel. Too bad he's dead.
What if he isn't? His brother left for Montana the day after the fire in his mother's shed. He had no business dealings there, no known friends, nothing.
Maybe he likes to ski.
Maybe. But let's just say Jacob Clark is still alive. Wouldn't you like to know what it is about him that scares the Colonel so badly?
Well, Becky, he turns out to be a Colonel in intelligence. Owen Crawford. He's the head of a classified operation that has something to do with unidentified flying objects.
My saucers?
Uh-huh. Remember those guys?
This is what you've been doing? All those weekend trips, you've been spying on these guys?
Last 3.5 years.
You could get locked up for this, Tom. They do that.
Only if they can catch me. Listen, Becky. Whatever else may have happened to Mom, this guy broke her heart. My life is not going to be complete until I ruin his. It's as simple as that for me.
In this year alone, we have put 2 men, John Glenn and Scott Carpenter, into orbit. And the Telstar satellite has successfully telecast from outer space. Your world is different than the world of your parents and teachers in ways that none of us can yet fully imagine. Dr. Greenspan.
Sorry to bother you. Please go on with your class.
Thank you.
Jacob?
Yes?
Do you mind staying under there a while longer? I'm not sure I convinced our friends that you were already gone.
Dr. Greenspan?
Yes, dear?
Those men are following us.
What do you want me to do?
Go a little bit farther. Don't worry, I won't let them hurt you.
She hits 87 and goes north. She's heading for Canada.
I hate driving in the dark like this. It makes me nervous.
She goes south. She could be heading for Billings.
What if we hit a deer or go off the road? I mean, it's really dark. I have an astigmatism, you know. My night vision is not to be trusted.
Do you want me to drive, Marty?
How's your night vision?
Inside the car, so I can shoot her. The kid won't get hurt.
Here they come.
Okay, on three. Stop the car and lay down flat on your seat. It'll be all right. One, two, three.
My fellow citizens, this government, as promised, has maintained the closest surveillance of the Soviet military buildup on the island of Cuba. Within the past week, unmistakable evidence has established the fact that a series of offensive missile sites is now in preparation on that imprisoned island.
The purpose of these bases
can be none other than to provide a nuclear strike capability against the Western Hemisphere. Upon receiving the first preliminary hard information of this nature,
I want you to put me in touch with whoever runs the UFO program.
At 9 a.m., I directed that our surveillance...
We're in the middle of a crisis here, in case you hadn't heard.
We have now confirmed and completed our evaluation of the evidence.
There is no UFO program that's run by the United States Air Force or any other branch of the government.
I don't believe that.
You're gonna have to go now. I'll call someone to have you escorted off the base.
Several of them include medium-range ballistic missiles, capable of carrying a nuclear warhead.
My father's in your hospital. He has something in his brain. The doctor says it's a tumor they can't operate on.
Very sorry to hear that.
I have an identical tumor in my own head. I believe these tumors are put there. Put there by whoever comes to those unidentified flying objects the United States Air Force or any other branch the government knows nothing about. Our fathers fought together. That has to count for something. I don't expect you to believe me, but I expect you to help me.
Aware of our dangers, but the greatest danger of all would be to do nothing. The path we have chosen for the present is full of hazards, as all paths are, but it is the one most consistent with our character and courage as a nation and our commitments around the world. The cost of freedom is always high, but Americans have always paid it. And one path we shall never choose, and that is the path of surrender or submission.
Tell anybody I gave you this name, I'll deny it.
But the vindication of right, not peace at the expense of freedom.
This guy's a colonel at Groom Lake,
in
Las Vegas.
Here in this hemisphere.
Thanks.
And we hope around the world, God willing, that goal will be achieved. Thank you and good night.
What's all this?
The market is almost out of supplies. Never seen the shelves so cleared out. They were so crowded, I got everything I could.
Expecting a world war?
You heard the president's speech? Don't give me that smirk, Colonel. Just because you're in charge of the Little Green Men Project doesn't mean you know all the secrets. Did you know that, boys? Your daddy's big, important secret job is to figure out if we're being attacked by Martians.
You're drunk, Ann. You shouldn't take the car out when you're drunk.
He stole that job from my father. I don't know how you did that. He took my daddy's job.
Get these groceries in the house, now. You should really be more careful about what you say in front of the children, Ann.
I am a man of constant sorrow.
The guy had to get a haircut.
I think you look serious.
Seriously stupid. And this song is no beat.
I don't think it's supposed to have a beat.
Boys, you must be done with all your homework.
You just wanted to listen to some music first.
You always could do your work at the last minute. But you're setting a bad example for your big brother. And don't look so bent out of shape. You're not the straight-A student. You're not the one who can afford to spend an evening by the record player.
I finished my homework at the library, sir.
I guess that's easier than having your mother spill her drink all over it. You guys worried about this missile crisis?
I figure if there was gonna be a war, you'd know about it.
You guys worried about your mother? People dig their own graves, boys. That's something you do well to remember. These are her problems she's dealing with, not yours. You're my sons, and I'm gonna take care of you both. You don't need to worry about that.
Is it true? Are you really in charge of some UFO project?
No, absolutely not. You guys have the number of my private phone at the office? Need to go in for a while this afternoon and see what I can find out about this crisis. If anything around here gets out of hand, I want one of you to call me, all right? It's kind of catchy.
Crawford. My name is Jesse Keyes. My father's name is Russell Keyes. He was a pilot over in Germany in the Second World War. He and I have both had encounters with unidentified flying objects. We've both been inside them. They've come for us. They've taken us. And they're going to come for us again.
Get in the car.
Yes, sir.
You know in cartoons, the way someone can run off a cliff and they're fine, they don't fall until they look down. My mom always said that was the secret of life. Never look down. But it's more than that. It's not just about not looking. It's about not ever realizing that you're in the middle of the air and you don't know how to fly.
Whatever they did to me. Killed all the members of my crew. I don't know why it didn't kill me. And I tried to run from it, but then they started taking Jesse. They seem more interested in him now than in me.
You're talking about the tumors.
They are not tumors. They are something that they put in our heads.
Possibly. And it's a shame we can't take a closer look. The doctors tell me they're lodged in an operable spot.
Someone put them in, then someone ought to be able to take them out.
Well, we can take them out, son, but it would kill you. You have a very brave son. Be willing to go head on at danger, to fly blind. You should be proud of them.
It's not like they left us much of a choice.
Still, you're a very brave young man. A little foolish, very brave. You go right at a thing. The initiative, for example, with which you found me. We are, for reasons I'm sure you both can imagine, a highly sensitive and secret group. People are as worked up as they are right now over a couple of Russian missiles in Cuba. Imagine how they'd react to a sky full of flying saucers. And so we have officers out in the field. Their cover is as regular military officers, but their real job is to screen the stories that come to us, you know, separate the wheat from the chaff.
You mean Lieutenant Wiley works for you?
Wiley? Yes, he's one of ours. Your son did the right thing by coming to us. We can help you. What do you make of this?
You are familiar with the work Dr. Watson and Creek are doing now, for which they won the Nobel Prize?
Yeah, genetics, yeah.
Yeah, yeah, that's what this is about. Traits that run in families. Our friends are looking for something. In the Keyes family, they have found at least some part of whatever it is they're looking for.
And the tumors?
Perhaps it is some unfortunate byproduct of being taken into an alien environment. Or perhaps it is something that is put there for a purpose. It could be, for example, something as simple as a tracking device that allows them to know where the test subjects that are most important to them are.
We should find out more.
Definitely.
Where are Erickson and Bowen? Any word?
I haven't been able to ascertain that, sir.
You don't have much of a future, son. Anyone ever tell you that? Captain, what's happening here?
Just been put on DEFCON 2, sir. We're preparing for attack.
I knew that Ivy League idiot Kennedy was going to cause trouble. I would have bet you dollars the donuts.
You feel good now? Are you rested? Well fed?
Never better.
You want to tell me why you were sitting in the middle of nowhere staring off into space?
We were looking for the Northern Lights.
You can't see the Northern Lights this time of year.
We were misinformed.
What the hell's going on here?
You know about Cuba?
Is that why you guys are up here?
I didn't say that. You ever play football?
Sure.
You send your man deep, defense moves to cover him, hole opens up, you just walk right on through.
You think the Russians are coming through the back door here? Is that what you're saying?
Oh, I'm not saying a thing. Just asking if you ever played football.
None of this explains what the two of you were doing staring out your windshield at nothing.
Nope. It doesn't, does it?
You all right?
What did that kid do to us?
I think we got a little taste of why Colonel Crawford was so afraid of him.
Jacob's in the back seat. We were followed. Jacob stopped them.
Jacob did? Is he all right?
Oh, well, he's in a lot better shape than they are.
Jake? Hi.
He's a very special boy. Take care of him.
Hey, Jake.
You've seen them, haven't you?
Mr. Keyes, should you be up and around?
I saw it in your eyes. You've seen them.
Can I fix you a drink?
I'm here to make sure you don't hurt my son.
Hurt your son.
You want the things they put in our heads. You can have mine. Take it out, do whatever you have to do. But it ends there, and I want your word. You'll never do anything to my son.
Yes. I've seen them. I would think you'd be more concerned with what they might do to Jesse than with anything that could happen because of us.
I don't know how to stop them.
Yeah, but you think I need stopping. And you think you can do that, Mr. Keyes. We would never do anything to harm a private citizen. We would never do anything to a citizen against his will. I personally would never do anything to harm a child. How old is Jesse?
16.
Okay, a young man.
Do we have a deal?
In the war, you enlisted in the Air Corps, am I right? Thank you for volunteering to help your country again.
Mom? Yeah, I'm all right. Mom, I'm with Dad. He didn't take me, Mom. I went to see him. It was my idea. I don't know when I'll be back. Mom, I love you. I'll be all right. I gotta go.
Too much trust for people, kid. That's your problem.
That's the boy. I saw the lieutenant here give him specific figures, numbers, types of planes, payloads. At the time, I didn't realize what they were doing, but when the DEFCON order came through...
You tricked me. You're supposed to help us, you tricked me.
Kind of young to be a spy.
A spy? What the hell are you talking about? You were supposed to help me and my father. What about the flying saucers? What about the UFOs?
Must be hopped up on something. Give him the nerve to do what he tried to do. I just pray to God he didn't manage to deliver his information.
I'll notify the Pentagon. Let them know we may have a breach.
Where's my father? I want to see my father!
You look at three things at the commodities page, like the price of poultry, cottonseed oil, and tin. This is what I did, and all three of them are stable.
And this is how you tell there isn't gonna be a war?
Now, what would they serve you in the army? Chicken. What does that chicken come out of? A tin can. What is that chicken sitting in? Cottonseed oil.
Yeah. All right, so in a war situation, you have more soldiers.
Eating more canned chicken, my point exactly.
And it doesn't wash.
Of course it washes. The hell, it doesn't wash.
No, this is the nuclear age. They drop a bomb, nobody's eating anything, end of story. What do you think? Is this a nuclear age or what?
Where's Colonel Crawford? Why isn't he here?
I don't know what Colonel Crawford.
This thing will go all night? Because we're still here in daylight. There's a sweet little Studebaker over there I wouldn't mind taking a look at.
Good evening, Mr. Keyes. I want to thank you for letting us take a closer look at that tumor of yours.
Where's Crawford?
Colonel Crawford has an entire operation to oversee. He's left this particular face of it in my capable hands.
Well, I don't do anything until I talk to Crawford. I need to know that my son is safe.
I might be mistaken, but it does not appear to me that you are in a position here to make demands. Prep him.
Doctor, he's seizing.
Bring on again, Steve.
Tin and cottonseed oil.
What's going on?
Tin and cottonseed oil.
Tom? Becky? And you must be Jacob.
Jake's a little tired.
Come in. Come in. We've been waiting for you ever since Dr. Greenspan got in touch with us.
They seem like really nice people.
We wish you could just come home with us, Jake.
Do you still do card tricks?
No. Kind of gave that up after we made you disappear. You gonna be all right?
I just need some rest. I'll be fine.
No, listen. Try not to do anything. We don't want any stories getting out about you.
You don't have to worry about that. I can't do that stuff anymore.
What do you mean?
Well, I guess it's kind of like a battery that runs out of charge. I knew I didn't have much left, but those men were going to hurt Dr. Greenspan. I couldn't let that happen.
You take care, Jake.
You too.
We can start with where the hell were you and work our way up from there.
You told us to bring you a smoking gun. We were following a lead. A schoolteacher in Montana claimed she'd been taken.
And?
Dead end. I'm just another lonely lady looking for a little attention.
I hope you're able to give her some.
Well, there were a few stories up there. Actually, I wouldn't mind getting back up there to take another look around.
I'm sure you wouldn't. Oh, we had an interesting time of it while you were gone. There's a classified report you both should take a look at.
Alu, Erinnerungen kommen auf einmal. Alu, Erinnerungen alle Ängste.
All your memories play at once. All your memories and all your fears.
Howard, you stay for a moment? Need your help with something at home. It's a personal thing. Something going on with Marty?
How do you mean?
He feels to me like someone about to try an end run. Keep an eye on him. I rely on you completely. You're my eyes and ears out there, Howard.
Yes, sir.
What happened? Russian shot down one of our U-2s. Bad time to be a spy, kid. Time of war, they shoot you.
What's this?
Bomb shelter.
Why?
Like they're gonna tell me.
Hey, did you hear about Henderson and Slide? They're escorting a patient from the hospital, some sort of secret surgery. Something went wrong. Big explosion, everyone's dead.
The patient from the hospital, do you know his name?
It's like talking to you.
Do you know the name of the man that they were transporting? Who was he?
I don't know his name. Whoever he was, he's dead.
The world is made up of the big things that happen and the small ones. And the part that's so unfair is that we call them big and small. Because when something happens to you, when you lose something or someone that you really care about, that's all there is. The world may be blowing up around you, but you don't care about that. You don't care about that at all.
Favorite, you know that? You always were. I hope it doesn't ruin your life. That's it. His favorite, your birthday. 7/28/51.
What is it?
Part of your inheritance. Your mother and I need to talk. Come on out. Out, come on.
My father told me about this. It's from that spaceship.
What do you mean? What spaceship?
The one you and Daddy found up at Pine Lodge. He said you used this to take the project away from him. You know, it broke his heart when he lost the program. I think that's what killed him.
Your father had a drinking problem, Anne. He imagined things. What killed him was cirrhosis of the liver. You know that. I'm an intelligence officer, Anne. I have never had anything to do with any kind of spaceship.
You're lying. You're a liar.
What you're holding is a piece of an experimental plane the Air Force is working on. I thought I'd get it mounted for Sam. He seems to like that sort of thing. I'm so single-minded in my work, I don't give you enough. You or the boys. You remember the first time I took you riding? You almost fell off. I want it to be like that again for us. It's the most important thing in the world to me, Anne. Please forgive me. And please say you'll give me one more chance, okay? Do something about the pills and the liquor. You know that. You can't go on like this. There's a place in Oregon. It's very comfortable and very discreet. It's a 6-week program, and I made some calls. You can leave tonight. Okay? It's best for the boys. And we'll all be here waiting for you when you get back. Okay? I'm sorry.
Howard, thanks for coming. You can understand I wanted to keep this, you know, close. I truly appreciate you doing this for me and for my family.
Well, I'm happy to help out, Colonel.
And, slow and easy on the curves. My wife's in a delicate state, okay? And Howard's here.
Ma'am? I'll take that, sir.
Tell the boys I love them?
Yes, I'll tell them. And I'll tell them you're gonna be just fine. And when you come home, we'll go riding again, okay?
Okay.
See you soon, okay?
Okay.
States promises not to invade the island.
This brings to an end.
Well, I guess we came pretty close to glowing in the dark.
President Kennedy characterized Premier Khrushchev's backing down as, quote, an important and
Secretary of State. You don't live long in that kind of hurry. I don't know why he's going so fast. Trailer, here's some music.
Yeah, I think so.
Me too. No, no, not at all.
That's all we've got.
Right, that's not too bad. What the hell is that?
You won't believe me, sweetheart, but I'm really sorry about this.
I have some terrible news. Okay. Sometimes grown-ups, married grown-ups, get the idea that they don't want to be married anymore. And they start to see other people. Something like that has happened with your mother. You remember Captain Bowen who worked for me?
Howard, sure.
He and your mother have been seeing each other. Apparently last night they decided to go away together. They were in Howard's car going up over the Sierras and police don't know exactly how it happened. Looks as if your mother changed her mind about leaving us. And Howard tried to stop her. And look, sometimes when grown-ups care about something, things can get a little confused. She's gone, boy. I'm so sorry, she's gone. She was the sun and the moon to me. I'm so sorry.
I have this idea about why people do the terrible things they do. Same reason little kids push each other on the schoolyard. If you're the one doing the pushing, then you're not going to be the one who gets pushed. If you're the monster, then nothing will be waiting in the shadows to jump out at you. It's pretty simple, really. People do the terrible things they do because they're scared.
That's all we found in the wreckage. Bodies in this film.
Russell Key's body?
Missing the piece of skull the surgeon cut out, yes.
Any sign of the thing that they put in his head?
Well, the forensics people tell me there was a tiny hole in Russell Keyes' frontal lobe where this thing could have been lodged, but no. It must have been destroyed in the fire.
After first doing this to a room full of people. You're probably wondering why I wasn't in that room. Over the years, Marty, I've found that I have a good gut. A little twinge that tells me when I might do better to be cautious. One of the luxuries of being in charge, you get a twinge like that, you can have other people take your risks. Marty, I appreciate your loyalty and all this. I'm not gonna forget you. And now that Howard's gone, you're gonna be in a position of greater and greater responsibility. I hope you're up to the challenge.
Yes, sir.
What was he looking for in Montana? What did he think that he could find there that he could use against me?
He thought that Jacob Clark was still alive.
Was he?
Are you going to show this film to the president?
No, I don't think so. Now that he saved the world, the son of a bitch is going to be even more insufferable.
You really think he'll shut us down?
Or make us pencil pushers?
So what do we do?
We just bide our time. Keep the other one on ice.
Jesse Keyes.
Yeah, the doctors tell me the thing in his head is identical to the one in his father's. We just bide our time and keep him on ice. That pretty boy won't be president forever.
These were your old man's.
We're all standing on the edge of a cliff, all the time, every day. A cliff we're all going over. Our choice isn't about that. Our choice is about whether we want to go kicking and screaming, or whether we might want to open our eyes and our hearts to what happens once we start to fall.